Why? Because he is independent. He also does not need a reason. He is independent. He does not need a reason. Therefore, who can ask why? He is the Supreme Lord. Everything works under his control. He is not under the control of anyone. But still, he likes to please his devotees. Therefore, Krishna is controlled not by anything else, but he is controlled by the prema of the devotees. Therefore, Krishna himself, he is Atmaram Aptakam. He has no unfulfilled desires. He has no material lust. But still, Krishna has one great quality, which may appear to be a weakness, but it's not a weakness, it's his ornament. That is his bhakta vatsalyata. Krishna is controlled by the affection of his devotees. Therefore, seeing the desire of the Brijavasis to serve him, Krishna felt a desire to perform Rasalila, to fulfill the hearts of the Brijavasis.
Jnana kimiram tasya jnananjana shlakaya chakshuran militam jena tasmai shri gurave namaha vancha kalpatrubhyascha kripa sindhubhya evacha putitanam bhavanebhyo vaishnavebhyo namo namaha. Shri Gurudev is asking the devotees why Krishna has performed Rasalila. Krishna has two important qualities. One is atmaramata. Shripad Damodar Maharaj has explained. This means that Krishna is satisfied in himself. So he has no need for accepting any help, any service from anybody outside, because everything is happening within himself. He's fully satisfied within himself. He can fulfill all desires. Srila Gurudev has explained Atmaram. What does Atmaram mean? Satisfied with himself. That self means Shrimati Radhika. So, Atmaram means he's performing Ram, he's performing Raman. Beautiful activities with Shrimati Radhika, who is the very soul of his soul. Like, for example, when Krishna met with Shrimati Radhika at Kurukshetra, Shrimati Radhika was reminding Krishna of the suffering of the Brajbasis. She said, it's so wonderful that you've forgotten Govardhan? You've forgotten the place where we performed Rasalila? You've forgotten your mother, your father? I don't mind for my own suffering, but when I see my father and when I see Mother Yashoda, Nanda Baba, how they're suffering, it's intolerable. So when Krishna heard this, he began trembling. And he said that actually the Brajbasis are my life. And the gopis especially. And amongst the gopis, you are Jivanera Jivan. You're the life of my life. So Shrimati Radhika is Atma of Krishna. So Atma Ramata and then Pararamata. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur has explained that when Krishna's Atma Ram, there's no rust. This is dry. If he needs no help from anybody else. So Pararamata means he does need help from others. But from whom? Only from those pure devotees who only have love for him. He has no attachment to any material thing. He has no inclination to enjoy the material energy. Everybody loves Krishna, and Krishna loves love, but pure love for him. So, actually this is the life. Krishna's life is his loving exchanges with his devotees. So when Krishna saw the moon rising on the full moon, Sharad season, immediately he remembered the face of Srimati Radhika. Moon was rising and putting red everywhere. So he thought, oh, moon is putting kumkum on eastern direction, who is the wife of somebody else.
No, I want only
one
point. Five he did drops. So your point is okay. Thank you. Moreover, if you can say more.
Om Gyanatunandhasya Gyanandana Slakya Chakshur Nmulitam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Nama. First of all, I offer my Sastang Dhanavat Pranam at the lotus feet of Asmadiya Paramaradhatama Guru Pada Padma, Om Vishnu Pada Stodara Satsi Simat, Bhaktivedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj. I offer my pranam to my whole Guru Parampara and to all the assembled Vaishnavas and Vaishnavis. So Srila Gurudev has ordered me to speak a few words. Why Sri Krishna performed Rasa Lila? So we know that the sages of Dandakaranya, in their previous lives, they performed austerities to attain Krishna as their beloved. And therefore, in their next life, they became gopis. So it's Shukadeva Goswami said, Anugrahaya Bhaktanam, in order to bestow his mercy on those devotees who had performed austerities for many lifetimes to gain the position of his beloveds, Krishna has performed this Rasa Lila. Not only the sages of Dandakaranya, but the young girls of Janakpuri. When Sita married with Lord Ram, many other young ladies there were attracted to Ram, but he could not marry them because he took a vow to only marry one person. So they are the princesses of Janakpuri. In their next life, they became gopis and Krishna performed Rasa Lila to accept them as his beloveds. Also, when Sita was in exile at that time, under the guidance of his Gurudev, Sri Ramachandra, he made so many murtis of Sita Devi to be with him at the time of Jagya. Each one of these Swarna Sitas, golden Sitas, was actually alive. And they also, next life, became gopis and met with Krishna in Rasa Lila. The Vedas personified had done austerities to become gopis, and they became the Shruti Chari gopis. In order to fulfill their desires, Krishna performed Rasa Lila. During the season of Hemanta, the month after Kartik, so many Sadhan Siddha gopis, they worshipped Katyayani for 1 month. And on the last day of their brat, Krishna came and stole their clothes. And he promised them that in Shard season, I will fulfill your desire that I will become your beloved. So many sadhaks from everywhere, from different places, had been doing hard austerities and very strong bhajan for lifetimes to attain the position of being Krishna's beloved. So on that night of Rasa Lila, he accepted them. So these are reasons, but these are not prominent reasons. Srila Shukadeva Goswami, in the first verse of Rasa Lila, he said, Bhagavano Pitharatri Shardutfulla Malika Rantamasin Manaschakre Yogamaya Upasata. On the night of the Rasa Lila, the fragrance of the Malika flowers filled the air and Krishna himself was inspired. Rantamasit Manas Chakre, he made up his own mind. He wanted to perform this Leela because Krishna is Rasika Shekhar. The Vedas say, Taittiriya Upanishad, Raso Vaisaha, Sa Evayam Labdwanandhi Bhavati. The supreme truth is the ocean of Rasa, Prema Rasa Nir Jasa Karite Ashwadan. Krishna comes in this world to relish Rasa. But how can he relish Rasa? Only by serving the lotus feet of Srimati Radharani. So during Rasa Lila, Krishna, he played his flute, and by his flute he called the name of Radhika. But all other gopis heard, and they also came. But mainly it was to meet with Srimati Radhika. And during that Rasa Lila, Sri Krishna, he disappeared, and took Radharani with him, alone. And they performed beautiful pastimes in Sringarvat. And there Krishna, being Rasik Shekhar, the enjoyer of all rasa, he relished the opportunity to decorate the lotus feet of Srimati Radhika, to comb the hair of Srimati Radhika. But when he saw that, he heard that other gopis were coming and about to find them, then Krishna disappeared. And Radharani began to cry, Hanata Ramana Preshta, Kwasi Kwasi Mahabuja, oh my beloved, where are you, where are you? Please accept me. And the other gopis saw Radharani's separation. So previously, other gopis thought they love Krishna, others love Krishna, we all love Krishna. But when the other gopis saw the separation mood of Radharani, it was like a vast fire. And theirs was just like a glowworm in comparison. Then they could all understand that Radharani's prema was the highest. So especially to serve the lotus feet of Radhika and to glorify the lotus feet of Radhika, Sri Krishna has performed this Rasalila because he is Rasika Shekhar.
Moreover, there are something. Moreover, something. That is, Siddhar Swami, Sanatana Goswami has told, Rasalila is Kam Vijay. Kam Vijay means to defeat Kam Dev, Cupid. In the night, full night, full moon, very beautiful wind, breeze. All kinds of flowers in Bhujan. On the bank of Jamuna River, alone Krishna and thousand of gopis surrounded Krishna. Here, Kamdev, Cupid, he was very proud that I have conquered Shankar, I have conquered Brahma. Brahma made a very beautiful girl, Mohini, and he was so much attracted to her. Also Indra, he was attached to Patni of Gautam Rishi, Chandra to wife of his guru. So all demigods and even Brahma and Shankar, he has conquered. So he has so false ego. So Krishna, what did? So beautiful moon night, breeze coming on the bank of Yamuna, alone Krishna, thousand of gopis, young age, very beautiful, and having all qualities, surrounded by them, and Krishna, what doing? Or touching their bodies. But even he told, oh, go to your husbands and serve them. Not only that, he disappeared, even giving up Radhika also, weeping. So Krishna is Cupid of Cupid, he is Kam Mohan. He can conquer, he has conquered really Kamdev. And one thing more, Vikriditam Bajubadubhi Ijant Vishnu Sadhvanvitam Anushriyadat Bardiyedaya Bhakti Param Bhagavati Pratilabhya Kamam Hridrog Rasu Apihinuk Tachirade. Those with very strong faith, they will hear. What is a strong faith? Like Haridas, like Prahlad Maharaj. Oh, anyone cut me in pieces, I will not give up Harinam or devotion of Krishna. So a strong faith in Krishna. Right? And by hearing this Harikatha, if anyone has faith that all kinds of Hridrog will go away, so he is telling, Vikriditam Pradubhi Idancha Vishnu Anushriyat Atha Varniyatya. Those who have heard from his Gurudev and hearing, and then to describing to others. Dhir. Dhir means whose intelligent is sober. Sober. What? If anyone telling that no, by Rasalila hearing, lust will not go, they are what? They are aparadhi.
Offender.
Because in Srimad Bhagavat, Sukadeva Goswami has told, Narad Rishi has told, Vyas Dev has told. So this person, he has no faith in all this. So she is very aparadhi, offender. They cannot, their lust will not go. But other, Gosvardhi, with sattva, those will hear Hari Katha, these sweet pastimes. First, bhakti will come. What kind of bhakti? Like gopis will come. And then, very soon, lust will go. In Gita or other description, it has been told first, lust will go, and then, but Ras Leela not so. First, bhakti will come in your heart, and then lust will go. This is the object of Krishna. Go, Premanand. Now you should.